Filipino consumers turned less optimistic on the economy in the first quarter of the year. That finding made public by the central bank on Friday in its Consumer Expectations Survey report. The BSP says the overall confidence index remained in the negative, but improved to negative 10.9%. Monetary authorities say the improved outlook is due to expectations of additional and higher income and the availability of more jobs, among others. But consumer outlook for the second quarter and for the next year turned gloomier in anticipation mainly of higher inflation. The BSP survey also found Filipinos still expect borrowing rates to go up and for the Philippine peso to weaken against the dollar.
The Philippine Tollway Authority says motorists will see a 50% reduction in toll fees when using the 14-kilometer Cavitex if its management is turned over to the government. For more on that story, let's bring in our correspondent, Andrea Taguines. Andy, go ahead.
Hi, Denise. The Public Estates Authority Tollway Corporation, or PEATC, reiterated its mandate to operate and maintain the Manila to Cavite Toll Expressway Project, or Cavitex, as well as to collect toll. Earlier this week, the PEATC, which is a subsidiary of the Philippine Reclamation Authority, asked the Court of Appeals to issue a writ of mandamus to compel the private contractor, Cavite Infrastructure Corporation, to hand over the reins for the 14-kilometer expressway. Based on the petition, the CIC's authority to operate and maintain the toll roads already expired back in 2021. Speaking with ABS-CBN News, PEATC spokesperson Attorney Ariel Inton also stressed the huge revenue that the government is missing out on because of the current 90-10 revenue sharing ratio in favor of CIC. According to Inton, the joint venture agreement for the project states that the income sharing should have shifted to a 60-40 ratio in favor of the government once the private contractor recovers its investment. The PRA also called for accountability and transparency from CIC on this matter, saying it is, quote, inconceivable that CIC has not yet recouped its equity after nearly three decades. The PEATC claims that Cavitex generated more or less 2.4 billion pesos in gross revenues in 2023 alone. Meanwhile, Inton said that motorists may also enjoy a 50% reduction in toll if Cavitex is turned over to the PEATC. Some motorists we interviewed welcomed this possible development, but there are also others who expressed concern that the quality of service may suffer under the hands of the government.
Sana ay makuha natin to dahil it will really benefit the Filipino people. Imagine kapag ka 60-40 na ang hatian in favor of the government, yun binabayaran toll ng ating mga motorista dyan sa Cavitex ay bababa, considerably bababa.
If that's the case, mas agreeable ako doon. Siyempre, yung centavos na masisave pagdaan nila, makakatulong sa mas marami. Mas makakadagdag yung sa gasolina.
Merong pros and cons eh. Marami tayong pag nata-transfer sa government, bumababa nga pero pangapangit yung service.
Before filing a case in court, Inton said the PEATC already sent several demand letters to CIC, which is under the Manny Pangilinan-led Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation, but to no avail. But in a statement, MPTC President and Chief Executive Officer Rogelio Singson said the company has already been meeting with the PRA and the PEATC to discuss their concerns on the revenue sharing. He added that their court action will be responded to properly. Denise?
And Andy? A cybersecurity analyst calls on the Philippine Congress to craft laws regulating artificial intelligence. Art Samaniego says it will be prudent for lawmakers to create measures addressing the risks of AI since it would likely be used for disinformation campaigns during the election season. He warns AI technology will continue to improve, making it even harder to spot manipulated videos and images.
We don't have a comprehensive law that covers all these things. So wala tayong batas dito. Ito yung danger. Election is soon coming in the Philippines, so this could also be used for disinformation. So a few months from now, the technology or the technique will be really improved. So ito ngayon ang delikado sa atin.